Keep in mind, Philadelphia played last night, a very emotional game. They also had to travel, got in late. If you come out hard in the first 5 to 10 minutes of this hockey game, if Philadelphia realizes that they're going to play a 60-minute battle, a war, it is going to help the Wild that much more.
Not surprising to see that tandem. Erickson, Ek, and Cunnan. Boudreau said yesterday they've been Minnesota's best forwards. And here's a long shot from Provorov that deflects and beats Dubnyk.
I don't know how many people it hit. Here's just a wrist shot, but it hit, looked like the body of Sealer or someone, and dropped straight down and bounced. I mean, this is a crazy goal just to have made it all the way through. Here it is. Off probably a skate, and then it bounces over Devan Dubnyk.
Centers, bouncing puck lands on the stick of Granlund. Granlund turns it back for Minnesota. Works his way up high. Down low, Parisi scores!
There's so many options in front of the net that Stolarz probably cheated a little bit there. He's figured, well, Parisi probably will go to the front of the net like the Wild have been doing, and instead, Parisi does the right thing, banks it off his shoulder, and puts one in there for the Minnesota Wild. Corey's 21, so I'm sure he's going to see plenty of more W's in his career.
Rask centers, comes free, Cunnan scores! He took advantage of a fortunate deflection, but makes no mistake. Cunnan stays hot. It's 2-1 Minnesota.
And it was played rather, well, rather nonchalantly in the slot by the defender. He just kind of threw it right back to Cunnan, and Cunnan just fires it home.
Back in behind for Erickson Ek. Erickson Ek avoids a check. Still with the puck in the corner. Tries to spin away from Giroux. Cunnan, a shot, he scores! Second of the night, and it's 3-1 Minnesota.
And it's kind of another kind of errant loose puck pass. Like, watch Erickson Ek. He'll lose it, but he loses it to the right spot. He gets knocked down, and he just kind of just throws one out there. And Cunnan just jumps all over it, very much like his first goal in this game. He's picking up loose change, and he's making them count.
Granlund up high, Spurgeon across Parisi, wanted the one-timer, instead Spurgeon. Granlund across Parisi, a shot, that was blocked. Parisi on the backhand, saved by Stolarz. Coyle still with it, his shot deflects wide. Stahl on it, back of the net, gives to Coyle. Coyle to Brodin, a shot, kicked out by Stolarz. And the Flyers finally gain control and clear.
You want to score first for so many reasons.
Wild have scored first less frequently than any team in the league. Only 33%
are trailing. You have to play a little bit differently. Sometimes you have to open things up a little bit more, play a little bit more risk-reward style of hockey.
Centering pass is deflected away. Wild clearly have more jump than the Flyers here through the first 25 minutes. Stahl to Greenway. What a save by Stolarz! They say the play's still alive. Looked like it caught the netting. This year he has only 10. Giroux with it here. To Gostisbehere up high. Back to Giroux. Gostisbehere. His shot deflects. They score. It was tipped on the way in. Simmons got a piece of it. He may not have been the only one. And the power play goal has Philadelphia within one.
Always putting the puck at the net. You saw that one catch a deflection and going between the pads. Right here, the shot, and then the redirect that goes the other way. You see Devan Dubnyk reach out with his glove? That puck was going glove side. The redirect, yeah, goes back the other way.
Giroux at center ice. 7 points in 6 games for Giroux, starting to find his game after a big year last year. And the Flyers have tied it on the deflection out front. Couturier puts it by Dubnyk, and we are even 3-3.
It's kind of lost, and Dubnyk thought he had every bit of that until it was just tapped between the pads. But this puck's actually, it's almost like a fanned pass because he kind of lost it, and it slid across the crease. And Giroux just kind of taps it between the pads.
And now Provorov leads a shorthanded rush for the Flyers. Provorov fires, and a pad saved by Dubnyk.
That was a very good shot. Used the defender as a screen. And Provorov got all of that one. Devan Dubnyk knocking that one down through the traffic.
pace of this game has accelerated a bit, particularly on the Philadelphia side here in the second. Tag shot. Splurge into Erickson and try to get it by Van Riemsdyk. Costas Bear lost it there. And Spurgeon feeds Cunnan. Cunnan for Foligno. He's able to deflect it into the corner. Foligno there, out to the line, Suter. Suter a long shot that goes just wide. Spurgeon holds. Spurgeon tried to center, and it's off the post.
How did that squirt? I think he might have even gone in behind Stolarz. If that did hit the post, that might have caught his back on the way through. Spurgeon roofs it. And even though Stolarz is hitting the net and it's knocking it up, it's the goaltender that's doing that. Well, I think you'll see that this one's going to count here for the Wild to put them up 4-3.
As the rebound played, the puck did come across the line. We have a goal.
Stahl now with it. Stahl dumped as he plays the puck out to center. Voracek back on the attack, drops for Giroux. A shot, he scores! Wild got caught in an awkward change, and Giroux beats Dubnyk for a 4-4 tie.
I think he's okay with it now. That is an absolute laser beam up over the glove. Little pass here gives Giroux the shot because he had a better angle to the net and a quicker opportunity to get that shot off, and boy, he doesn't make a mistake with that one.
Parisi at center, Granlund deflects it in. Seeler a shot, tip by Coyle and just out of the reach of Parisi. Across for Cunnan. Cunnan's the first one in, plays it back to Boteto. Boteto wanders in, a shot, and it's tipped just wide by Greenway. Now Zucker to Granlund. Had to go skate to stick, and then his shot was blocked by Gudas. Granlund has it back. To the line, Suter. Suter's long shot hit Parisi, a backhander saved by Stolarz. Tied up. Loose puck controlled by Couturier. Voracek back to Costas Bear, who hammers one toward the net, and they score. Costas Bear with a big shot from the line, and on the rebound, Van Riemsdyk able to jam it past Dubnyk, and the Flyers have the lead 5-4.
Now this shot comes all the way through, and boy, was there a lot of traffic on top of Devan Dubnyk there, but eventually they're just able to muscle that one towards the net.
Coyle lost it to Couturier. Erickson gives to Granlund. Granlund in. Dubnyk heads to the bench. Granlund shot kicked out Stolarz. Rebound off of Suter skate.
The Wild getting some chances late, but just can't find a way to get them past.
Provorov out to center. Parisi has it for Minnesota. Sends it to Granlund. Granlund floats it toward the net. Stolarz awkwardly deflects into the corner. Stahl tried to center, and it comes out to neutral ice. And for the second time this year, Philadelphia overcomes a two-goal Minnesota lead to beat the Wild. This time it's 5-4 in St. Paul.
Now there's going to be a lot of asking of questions here. How did this one get away from the Wild? They had the energy, they had the goals, they had a lot of things going in their direction, but just could not hang on.